Problema kasi dito sa lupa ng Pilipinas, eh, maraming nag-aagawan. Sinasabi nila na ito amin, may iba rin nagsabi na if we must establish some element of justice and peace in the country, that should be one of the policies of government to settle this issue of the land problems. In 1572, a royal decree was issued, which was Royal Decree of 1572 by the Royal Audienza, which was confirmed by the Supreme Court on May 5, 1583. Quote, respecting owners of the royal family to the entire archipelago with the exception of the island of Mindanao, which should be reverted back to the noble king's cousins, the three sultans of Mindanao, Sultan Sinsuat, Sultan Haji Kiramiswari, and Sultan Sironga, that it should be inherited by the families of the sultans. Now on January 17, 1764, a decree of 01-4 issued by virtue of supreme order of the Royal Crown of England, because the Philippines came under the direction of England from 1762 to 1764. And in accordance with the royal decree, there would be a continuity of the land holdings of the royal family that governed the country, which the Philippines governed the country from the 19th century, from the 9th century up to about the 17th century. And then in 1864, another royal decree was issued and registered anew in the name of Prince Julian MacLeod Taliano, a descendant and only son of Raja Suleiman and Princess Tarhata Kahar. No? People claim this land by reason of ancestral origins. Some people claim this land because it was donated by the friars. Other people claim this land because they used to be the datus in that area. So the claims have always been conflicting in any area of the country. Name the area. And the kind of problem that exists in Metro Manila exists also in those areas. You know, before, many of these lands were vacant. And any vacant land where they do not see anybody occupying can be titled with the use of fake decrees. Normally, a decree is based on a registration proceeding. When you file a registration proceeding, there is a decree issued by the court before a title could be issued. The decree defines the boundaries of the land based on our touring system. For instance, you take a look at the titles. Most of the titles originate from a decree. In many big lands in Metro Manila, the decrees come from other places. There are millions of fake titles in the Philippines as of today. One of the many millions of fake titles. I don't have to mention names, no, for now, but this is a property in San Jose del Monte. The original certificate of title from which it was taken is original certificate title number 166. LRA issued a certification that this so-called subdivision plan for a parcel of land in San Jose del Monte is for a parcel of land existing in two different towns of Quezon Province.
Ang titulong OCT-01-4 mula nang magkaroon ito ng visa.
Makapangyarihan because ito ang unang titulo na issue under the vectoring system. Under the vectoring system, dito sa ating batas, it is imprescriptible and indefeasible. Meaning, hindi mo mabaliwala ang 01-4 sapagkat walang titulo na mas early pa, mas nauna kay si 01-4. This is a torrent title issued by the government of the Republic of the Philippines before the Republic of the Philippines. It was issued under the land law. And then it was even revalidated in the cadastral law. So this is a torrent title. It cannot be defeated. If there is an earlier title, yes, 01-4 will be defeated.
Ayon pa kay Attorney Homobono Adaza, ang lahat ng titulo na hindi nagsisimula sa 01-4 ay peke.
Fake lahat yun. May certification ng Land Registration Commission, si Antonio Noblejas. Antonio Noblejas is the greatest authority on land registration law in the Philippines. Nagiging Land Registration Commissioner, nag-issue si Noblejas ng isang certification na nagsabi na ang 01-4, TCT-408, TCT-498 nasa kanilang records at ito mga genuine na titulo. At anumang mga titulo na mapalabas na hindi nagsisimula sa 01-4, piki yan. And spurious. Well, first, with respect to the land cases, no, we seriously believe that since a greater portion of the decision has already been executed long before this matter was elevated to the Court of Appeals, we believe that an independent action can be taken by way of enforcing the writ of execution and the return of the sheriff about the delivery of the lands involved in the litigation to the Italianos. Second, we are asking the Court of Appeals, I am filing a motion to decide the case immediately because this affects the whole country. It affects 85 million Filipinos. It does not just affect the Ayalas or the Ortigases, the Aranetas. It affects everybody. Ang punto dito eh, may mga titulo. Ang tanong, it's fantastic. It's fantastic for a man to go to the moon. But the man went to the moon, that's also fantastic. Daming nagsasabi, it's fantastic for a black man to be elected president of the United States of America. Will the fantastic happen? Obama became president of the United States of America. And this one is not even fantastic because there are titles validated by the government in a duly issued certification and validated by a compromise agreement signed by representatives of the government and validated by the court by issuing a decision recognizing it as within the law. After the issuance of the torrent system, the American government itself recognized OCT 01-4. Though these documents were recognized even long before the Americans came. And then in the 1960s, the Solicitor General of the Government of the Republic of the Philippines, in order to clear doubts with respect to the existence of this OCT 01-4, wrote a communication to the Land Registration Commission, which is now the Land Registration Authority that has supervision and control over torrent title and other documents related to land holdings. Out by leaps and bounds, as a matter of fact, there are properties which have three titles. And the reason for that is graft and corruption on the level of LRA plus the Register of Deeds. Sa pagsimula sa corruption ditong bansa natin, nangyayari ito because this is the easiest way of making money. And it's not easy to be immediately discovered that you grab lands. I think yung right ng gobyerno yan because mga masyadong mayayaman, mga oligarchs na yan. At yung oligarchs na kakabayad ng pera doon sa Register of Deeds and sa Land Registration Authority. Alam mo, dito sa bansa natin eh, pera is the greatest currency. Integrity, principles, the law are forgotten. simply because money is involved. And money leads to corruption. The reason, as they say, for every crime, for every huge wealth, for every great properties, there is also a huge crime behind it. And that's the case here. Land is the only thing that lasts. And any of the problems that's attended to land is beginning to last also in this country, unless the government does something about it. The central point, really, in the solution of this problem is with government. First, it should be a national policy on the part of the current administration, more especially the president, to solve these problems. How do they solve it? First, determine the genuineness of the titles and the genuineness and the validity of the ownership claims. And the current president keeps on saying that we should travel the straight road and not the crooked road, meaning there should be no graft and corruption with respect to the titles. It's about time that something is done about it by eradicating the fake titles, and only the genuine titles should remain. With our democratic experience and the provisions of the Constitution, it only depends on a president who knows his business and whose advisors know the law.
Of the Tala estate, which owns 01-4. I'll tell you, during the Spanish times, the whole country, before the Spanish time, the whole country was owned by the kingdom. Coco knows this all. by a kingdom that owns the whole Philippines. When the Spanish came, and the Queen of Spain realized that it's owned by King Luis I, also issued a pronunciamento of Hacienda Filipina. Hacienda Filipina was the whole country, okay, owned by the Taliano family. And then from Spain, somewhere along the way, the British were here for 2 years. The British also recognized the title of the Italianos. When the Americans came, this is what happened. In the Treaty of Paris, the Americans could not pay the Spaniard the amount, $25 million. The Italianos paid the $25 million. So, in the first registration period under the Torrens title, 01-4 was given by the Americans to the Italianos. Complete paper trail ito. During the time of Macapagal, pre-Macapagal days, the lawyers of the Italianos were the following people: Tanyada, Diokno, Elias, the best of the best, Marcos, Macapagal. That's why Macapagal had properties in Pampanga, among others, and Marcos had properties all over the place because part of the agreement, contingent agreement. So, what happened during the time of Macapagal? He asked Solicitor General, the Solicitor General, Makasiar, who later became Chief Justice, to ask Noblejas, this is in writing, okay, who, whether 01-4 and its derivative titles, TCT 498 and 408, are given. Reply of Noblejas, they are all genuine, they are sitting in our files, and any title that doesn't emanate from 01-4, 408, and 498 are fake and spurious. Okay. Case took place in 1971. In RTC, in Manila then, which later became RTC of Pasay City, branch 111. In the case, the Solicitor General Barredo at the time signed a compromise agreement recognizing 01-4 and its derivative titles, and the Italianos also recognized all government properties all over the country. They recognized, so it was decided in a compromise agreement. Portions of the decision was implemented in some places in Manila, it's so big, implemented in Manila. Came the time, after the decision became final and executory, the other parties, the landholders in Manila, were suspected to burn the Pasay City Hall together with all the documents of the Italiano, thinking that the Italianos no longer have copies of the original documents. Italianos have the copies of the original document. They filed a reconstitution of all the documents, including the title, and the Solicitor General also agreed that it should be reconstituted. Came the time of Gloria. Gloria. Gloria in excelsis. the properties of her husband and relatives would be affected. A decision that is more than 30 years old, more than cemented by time. You know, they filed a petition to annul the decision of more than 30 years. After filing this, the RTC denied. They went to the Court of Appeals. And strangely enough, the Court of Appeals made a contrary decision that it should not be reconstituted, which is now pending in the Supreme Court. Strange, very strange things. So the Gilman title is really 01-4.